Hello everyone, so welcome to another session in biochemistry. Here we are going to deal how a DNA is getting organized into a cell, inside the cell. In the case of eukaryotes, including the human beings, the DNA it is actually found inside the chromosomes that are located inside the nucleus. Right? In human beings, there's a set of 46 chromosomes and each chromosome having a DNA duplex. So total of 46 DNAs may be present, which may together make up to 2 meter long DNA, right? But the nucleus, it is just 10 micrometer in diameter. So how a 2 meter long DNA stretch is getting accommodated inside 10 micrometer diameter nucleus? That is where the organization is very important. Okay, so this particular problem, it is solved by packaging of the DNA, organization of the DNA, condensation and compacting of DNA well inside the cell, inside the nucleus. Okay, so how this is done? In prokaryotic cells, the DNA is organized as a single chromosome. Okay, and it is in the form of a circular double-stranded DNA. But in the case of eukaryotic DNA, what happens is it is a little more complex. Eukaryotic DNA and prokaryotic DNA, it differs in the association of DNA with specific kind of proteins. In the eukaryotic DNA, we can find that the DNA, the DNA duplex, the DNA double helical DNA, it is associated with histone proteins. Okay, and this is absent in the case of a prokaryotic DNA. Here you can see this is the double helical DNA. Okay, DNA duplex. What happens is the DNA duplex, it is wound around a histone core. Okay, histone, that is a protein. Okay, histone core. This structure which you can see inside, it is a histone core. Okay, and this one, it is the DNA double helix. Fine. So you can see it is wound around the histone core twice. Okay, it is two times it has been bound around, and this is how the packaging starts. Okay, the first step in the packaging, right? And when this is getting associated with the histone core, the structure what formed, it is known as a nucleosome. Okay, so in a eukaryotic cell, the DNA, it gets associated with different kinds of proteins, of which the histone proteins are the most important one, and it forms the next level of complex structure. It is known as a chromatin. So a DNA duplex, it gets associated with proteins to form the chromatin, and this chromatin is getting organized into further compact structure, which is referred as a chromosome. So that is how the complexity it increases. Okay, so how the first step, it is the formation of a nucleosome. So how a nucleosome is formed, it is actually DNA, it gets wrapped around the histone core. Okay, and here the histone core is formed of 8 histone proteins. Okay, you can see that it is formed of 2 molecules each of H2A, H2B, H3 and H4. So these 4 histone proteins are found in 2 sets, and these together form the histone core. Okay, if you just calculate the length of the DNA wound around, it is almost 146 base pairs starting from over here. Okay, starting from over here, if you calculate the length of the DNA wrapped around, it is 146 base pairs. Okay, so this structure is what is known as a nucleosome. Okay, now the DNA strand, it is placed perfectly on this octamer with the help of another histone protein, which is H1. Okay, you can see that the length of the DNA that forms a nucleosome, it varies from species to species. Okay, now coming to this structure, you can see this is one nucleosome, this is the second one. Okay, so here the stretch of DNA which is wound around the histone octamer or the histone core, it is known as a core DNA. So this is actually the core DNA. Fine. And this is the core DNA of this particular nucleosome, and here this is a core DNA of this nucleosome. But you can see a stretch of DNA placed between these two nucleosomes, and this DNA, it is known as linker DNA, or it is known as a spacer DNA. And it may range from 8 base pairs to 114 base pairs. Okay, so this is about the nucleosome. Now, how this nucleosome actually is found? So here you can see the DNA double helix, right? The width, that is just 20 angstrom, it is 10 2 nanometer, right? And these structures, it is actually the nucleosome, this one. Okay, so here you can see a nucleosome over here, the spacer DNA, the nucleosome again, a spacer DNA and a core DNA inside the nucleosome. This almost looks similar to a set of beads on a string. Okay, and this particular structure is known as a beads on a string form of chromatin. Okay, so the DNA double helix getting wrapped around the histone code protein, it results in the development of beads on a string form of chromatin. The histone core is composed of two molecules of histone proteins H2A, H2B, H3 and H4. Okay, and each core with two turns of DNA wrapped around is what is known as a nucleosome. Okay, and this nucleosome, it is a basic unit of chromatin. I suppose you may have heard about chromatin threads, isn't it? That is, the chromatin, it is formed of the nucleosome. And nucleosomes are separated by linker DNA or what is referred as a spacer DNA. And the stretch of DNA wrapped around the nucleosome is well placed on that with the help of the H1 protein. Okay, so this continuous string of nucleosomes, it is what is referred as a beads on a string of chromatin. Okay, and it is otherwise known as 10 nanometer fiber because of the thickness. You can see here, the thickness almost increased by 10 nanometer, from 2 to 10 nanometer. Okay, obviously the length has reduced. So you can see this length of DNA is formed only in a smaller stretch, isn't it? So the thickness increased while the distance covered by the DNA sequence, it has reduced. Okay, now the 10 nanometer fiber, what happens to that? The 10 nanometer fiber is further coiled to produce the 30 nanometer fiber. Okay, and this 30 nanometer fiber has a solenoid structure. You can see here, it has a solenoid structure, and it do have six nucleosomes in every turn of the solenoid. Okay, and now you can see 30 nanometer chromatin fiber composed of nucleosomes. Fine. Now, what is the next one? The 30 nanometer fiber further gets organized into loops. You can see here the loops, right? And this is supported by proteins and all. And this is the first stage of the formation of chromosome. Okay, till here we saw it is the chromatin, and here we can see it is the chromosome. So the chromosome, it is in an extended form, is what you can see over here, and the thickness is 300 nanometer. Okay, so it is 10 times it is increased from the 30 nanometer fiber. The next one, what happens is the 300 nanometer fiber, during the cell division, when the cell enters the cell division or the dividing stage, these loops, they further coil. Okay, this is just coiling. Okay, further gets coiled, and we get the condensed form of chromosome. Okay, so the coils of the chromosome, the extended form of the chromosome, it further coils, and this forms the condensed form of chromosome. By then, what happens is the thickness may have increased by 700 nanometer, and the distance, the length of the DNA, it may have highly reduced. Clear? Now, when the cell enters the cell division dividing phase, and the condensation may further increase, passing through the prophase and metaphase, and what happens is, the further condensation, further looping, folding and all, it will result in the metaphase chromosome, okay, which is actually the visible phase of the chromosome. And you can see the thickness may increase 1400 nanometer. Okay, so you can see here the 2 nanometer thick DNA double helix, by associating with the histone proteins, looping and folding and all, it has actually increased almost 700 nanometer thickness. The thickness have increased by 700 nanometer, and it has resulted in a very visible chromosome, okay, of 1400 nanometer thickness. Okay, right. So this is how it happens. You can see in the case of the cell, how it is. Okay, so this is a DNA duplex, which is 2 nanometer thick, you can see here. Okay, it gets associated with the histone proteins, right? And this is actually the thickness, it is 10 nanometer fiber. Okay, this increases by almost like the 5 times. Okay, so this is 10 nanometer thickness. And these nucleosomes, these are known as nucleosomes. Okay, these nucleosomes, they further coil. Okay, they pack into coil that twists into another larger coil, and this continues and it produces a highly condensed supercoiled chromatin fibers. So this is chromatin fiber. And it is 30 nanometer in thickness. And this 30 nanometer fiber further loops. You can see here the loops. Okay, this is supported by, again, proteins. And this looping results in increasing the thickness of 300 nanometer. Okay, the thickness increases to 300 nanometer. And this further, these loops further coil and form the chromosome, which is 700 nanometer. The 700 nanometer thick chromosome, it is usually in high non-condensed form. That is, it may not be visible, but it further condenses to result in the formation of a chromosome which is visible at the metaphase stage. Okay, and there it is almost like 1400 nanometer. So this is the this is how a DNA duplex, it gets organized inside the nucleus. Okay. I hope it is clear. That is passing through 2 nanometer, the DNA helix duplex, passing to 10 nanometer fiber, the chromatin fiber, 30 nanometer chromatin fiber, passing into 300 nanometer non-condensed chromosome or extended form of chromosome, and then 700 nanometer condensed form of chromosome, and 1400 nanometer thick metaphase chromosome. So this is how it is getting the steps through which the DNA duplex gets converted into a visible chromosome in a dividing phase. Okay, so this is about the organization of DNA inside a cell, inside a nucleus. Fine.